In 1 week, it's the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade with Joan Lunden, Regis Philbin, Kathy Lee Gifford, and John Davidson live.
Christmas morning here on ABC. Welcome back to the 1993 Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade. We'll be bringing you all the excitement from sunny Florida.
So everybody get comfortable because we have spared no expense in giving you a front row seat to the ultimate Christmas morning ever.
Actually, we have two incredible parades for you.
You see, Joan, other shows might try to get by with just one incredible parade, but not here. Not with this one, Joan. Two incredible parades.
Right here in the Magic Kingdom, we'll be seeing Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Parade, and then over at the Disney MGM Studios, Aladdin's Royal Caravan.
Plus, a great big bag full of extra Christmas surprises. In fact, this morning, we have such a big show, we put a Christmas correspondent in every park, just to keep us up to date with all the excitement.
So let's see what's happening elsewhere in this fabulous resort. First, someone that I think you may know, Reed.
No, she's not here, too.
Kathy Lee Gifford with a couple hundred Christmas fans at the Disney MGM Studios.
Everywhere. Merry Christmas, Kathy.
Hi, Regis. Hi, Joan. Reed, you just can't get rid of me, can you? Merry Christmas and happy holidays to everybody. We are having a fabulous time here at the Disney MGM Studios. A little later, Aladdin's Royal Caravan will be coming down Hollywood Boulevard with Aladdin and Jasmine and all your favorite characters. And you're invited to join me at the studio back lot for a look at how TV shows and movies are actually made. They're fabulous. But first, when it comes to science, Bill Nye, the Science Guy, is everybody's favorite. Here he is from EPCOT Center. Merry Christmas, Bill.
Thanks, Kathy Lee. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays, everybody. I'm Bill Nye, the Science Guy, your Christmas correspondent. From Disney's ever-changing, entertaining World's Fair of the Future, I refer, of course, to EPCOT 94! We'll be back in a bit with a look at new shows and attractions here at EPCOT 94, but right now, it's parade time. So through the control of electromagnetic waves, let's go back to Joan and Regis at the Magic Kingdom. Ready? Take it!
It looks like everyone is ready for a parade here, so let's kick off Christmas morning with the 225-piece Ohio State Marching Band under the direction of Dr. John R. Woods.
And how? The band's next date is at the Holiday Bowl in San Diego when the Buckeyes meet the BYU Cougars.
Today, though, they're playing Jingle Bells and Deck the Halls. Let's listen. A couple of Santa's elves are on hand to help start off the festivities.
They may be just two little elves, but when the people here catch their first glimpse of them each year, there's always tremendous applause.
Oh, now here's Mickey and Minnie.
Oh, that's the official start, right?
The official start. Coming down Main Street at the Magic Kingdom. Now look at the knights up there on horseback, Reed. And those are big horses. Now here's
the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
Go down to Main Street, USA now, where Robbie Benson is getting a first-hand look at what Christmas in the Magic Kingdom is all about.
Hey, take it from us. We're having an absolute blast down here on Main Street. This is my little boy, Zeppy, and people from around the world are here to have a blast. Hi, where are you from?
Washington State.
Washington State, where are you from?
Tennessee.
All right, where are you from?
Tennessee.
Tennessee, your family.
Yeah. Hi.
Where are you from?
Colorado.
Colorado.
How about you?
Japan.
Japan. Is this a Christmas present?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're live on national TV. Is there anybody here who wants to say Merry Christmas?
Hi, Utica.
All right. There you have it. They come from all over the world and for good reason. From where we stand, this is the most fantastic Christmas morning of all time. You hear that music? That's got to be the World Band. So let's go back to Joan and Regis for a better view.
And that's looking up Main Street right there, where the Royal Band is coming and heralding the arrival of your favorite, Cinderella.
Yes, Cinderella. And another favorite of mine, Major Mike. Now, how many years? Every year, Major Mike heads up this band and loves it. We love him.
A 26-member band made up entirely of Disney musicians, and they are great.
Major Mike, how proud he is.
There she is.
Cinderella. Ring. Cinderella in a pumpkin coach pulled by six Shetland ponies. Horses are just about 3 feet tall.
There she is. Hi, Cinderella.
Yes.
How you doing, babe?
Yeah.
That kiss is for me. I know it.
I know. She heard you. She was winking at you. I saw it. See, there she is.
She's back again. Another kiss.
Wait a minute. Now it's my turn. Hey, there's Prince Charming. Ah. Now Prince Charming's on a brand new steed.
Yes. An Arabian stallion.
There he is. Handsome fellow, isn't he? Hey, there's the little mice. Susie and Perla. Two little mice who helped sew that fabulous ball gown.
And they really are dressed fabulously.
And you'll see right there in the background, that's Fairy Godmother. She's the one that turned the pumpkin into the coach with those magic words, bibbidi bobbidi boo.
Why, absolutely.
It's such magic, you know, when they all come down the street. What a beautiful start to a fabulous parade. And there is so much more to come, including a musical tribute to everyone's favorite day of the year with Goofy and Scrooge McDuck.
I couldn't think of a better way to spend the morning than right here.
Well, you're in good company, Reed, because do you know where Santa's elves go on vacation after a whole year of work?
Where else does anybody go after a whole year of work but right here to Disney World?
That's right, Reed. And they are enjoying their well-deserved Florida vacation.
Our job is done.
We're in the pool.
The weather's warm, but we'll play it cool. We're on vacation. Having lots of fun.
V-A-C-A-T-I-O-N.
At Typhoon Lagoon.
We're gonna grab a bite at the ice cream stand.
Gosh, write love letters in the sand.
Oh, listen.
We're on vacation.
We'll splish splash together where we want to go.
I never looked at the clock. We're gonna hug and kiss, just like this.
And I can't wait to go, go, go. I'm gonna mash potato to a jukebox too.
Hide behind a red balloon.
We're on vacation.
Gonna have a ball.
Oh, boy!
Wishing you a Merry Christmas!
Coming up, Goofy, Dancing Reindeer, and Santa's Elves when the Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
Welcome back to Christmas morning at the Magic Kingdom, and we're just in time for a look at the sparkling Christmas spectacular right now.
Oh, 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 oh. Who's got a beard that's long and white?
Santa's got a beard that's long and white. Who comes around on a special night? Beard that's white.
Who's got a great big cherry nose?
Santa's got a great big cherry nose. Who laughs this way?
Oh, ho, ho!
Santa laughs this way.
Oh, ho, ho!
Cherry nose, cap on head, suit that's red, special night, beard that's white. Must be Santa. Santa Claus.
There's a day in history that's more than any myth. Beyond a doubt, one day stands out.
December the 25th.
Right, I don't hear any arguments, so may I say forthwith, I wish that every day could be
December the 26th.
December the 25th.
Humbug, December the 26th.
The dearest day in all the year.
December the 26th.
You don't seem to understand.
December the 25th.
I'm going to tell you one more time. December the 26th.
One last time. So may I say forthwith, I wish that every day could be
December the 26th.
December the 25th.
Humbug, December the 26th.
The dearest day in all the year.
December the 26th.
You don't seem to understand.
December the 25th.
I'm going to tell you one more time. December the 26th.
One last time.
December the 25th.
The characters here pull out all the stops at Christmas time.
And they'll be bringing us many more surprises as the Very Merry Christmas Parade continues. Now, coming up, we've got Aladdin's Royal Caravan. You don't want to miss that. Plus, a special song by Kathy Lee Gifford at the Disney MGM Studios.
I'm looking forward to that. Right now, though, it looks like all the excitement is down on Main Street, so let's check it out. There are the court dancers.
The court of Princess Aurora, right? Sleeping Beauty. They're leading the way for the princess and Prince Philip. Check out these costumes now. This is from the beautiful Emmy Award-winning wardrobe of this parade.
That's right.
He won the Emmy this year.
The largest working wardrobe in the world.
Wow.
There she is. There's Sleeping Beauty. And Prince Philip is up there behind her.
Now, he must have just given her the kiss to wake her up, right?
That's right.
That
kiss can work miracles, you know.
Well, look how radiant she is. What was Princess Aurora's... What was she renamed by the fairy godmother?
Briar Rose.
So you know everything about this.
Right back there, you see Flora and Fauna. Those are the fairy godmothers. And Merryweather, she's in the blue.
And this float is something else, too. It's entirely covered with glass and mirrors. Gives a magical effect.
There's a beautiful couple right there. Ah, oh, look at all the little folks watching.
Look at the face on that guy.
And here are their knights. The knights on horseback.
And check out these horses, Joan. I know you're a horse fan, but these are a couple of Belgian draft horses. They weigh about a ton each.
And if you stand next to one of them, you can't believe how big they are. Mm-hmm.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
Ah, here are our favorite little guys.
Everybody loves them, the seven dwarfs.
Now, a good way to remember them, I've just been told, they're two D's. Right, Doc and Dopey. Two S's, Sleepy and Sneezy,
right.
And three emojis, Happy, Grumpy, and Dopey.
Not a bad way.
Not a bad way to remember.
Now what?
That's Dopey right there up on the cottage.
Poor Dopey, he's got to stay home and mind the cottage, eh? And it looks like something's cooking in that cottage, too. Smoke coming out of that chimney?
Yeah.
These kids, people just love the dwarfs, though. You know, there's something, every one of those faces is so happy.
Some of their great songs are Hi-Ho and Whistle While You Work. That's one of my favorite ones.
Uh-huh.
The Wishing Washing Song and Silly Song. That's a good one. Now, following right behind them are the Christmas trees, except only here would you find dancing Christmas trees.
They just astound people. People wondering, now how are these trees actually dancing? Yes, they do dance on their own. With a little help from somebody, but...
And what would Christmas be without snow people? Kind of get a chill just looking at them. But they're not melting, though, down here
sure
in Florida.
Aren't.
Now, this is brand new this year. On this float, there's a little ice pond, and Snow White and Frosty are actually ice skating down Main Street.
That's a first, isn't it?
Yes, it's brand new. And they're pretty good skaters, too, by the way.
Snow White never changes.
You know, she was really Disney's first heroine. I mean,
yeah.
She got a whole bunch of new fans, though, since her movie was re-released, you know, last summer.
Big
it was
hit.
All restored, too.
Frosty really making the spins there on that ice. Not bad.
See, you can stare at some of the land.
I would say so. Can't believe it, an ice skating rink on Main Street.
Fabulous parade. Let's take a moment now to journey over to EPCOT 94 for Bill Nye,
the Science Guy.
And a preview of a great new attraction coming this summer. Take it away, Bill.
I was just watching a little television in these goggles. No kidding, look. There's a miniature television in here that puts things in focus way out here. Oh, yeah. I love the show. This guy cracks me up.
Science rules.
A little out of control, though. Boy, better pull back. Not right now, because there's lots to see. These virtual vision goggles are just an example of the kind of thing you'll see at Innoventions. It's new at EPCOT 94 this summer. So what's it all about? Well, come with me, we'll check it out. Innovation is what happens when you combine innovation with invention. And here at EPCOT 94, it's just the place for you and I to check out innovations. So, take a look at this. A lot of people have computers, right? Well, they're all about information. And now, computers can recognize your handwriting and send that information electronically all around the world. Now, a picture or a drawing, like the one you're watching right now, of me and this, is information. So suppose you could design your house, what would normally be a picture, in a computer. Then you could walk through the house electronically and get the house just the way you want it. That's innovation. Check this out. This is a laser. See the laser light? This is a pointer that business people and professors use to show people what they're talking about. Lasers are so small and compact now that people are using them to help them sink a putt. You know, a laser like this used to take up this entire room. Well, maybe not this entire room. I mean, we're at Disney World, for crying out loud. I mean, it's like science fiction. Well, speaking of science fiction, Innoventions has all kinds of wild technology. You can measure people's temperature without even touching them. You can clean your teeth using ultrasonic energy. And this device is so sensitive, you can measure your blood pressure with just your finger. Oh, by the way, keep it the same height as your heart or you'll get the wrong reading. Now, what does everybody want? What does everybody want? When you're on the phone, you want to see the person you're talking to. See that? Now, don't worry, if you're having a bad hair day or you don't look so good, you can cover the camera up with this thing. Oh, wouldn't you know it? The phone's ringing. What are the chances? Hello?
Hi, Bill. Hey, you look great, but it's time to go now.
I know. Hang on a second. You two can check out the future of science at EPCOT 94, only at Innoventions. You can check it out, Joan. Yeah, you can check it out. We can all check it out. I know, it's cool.
Hi, we're the Hayek family from Virginia Beach, Virginia. We'd like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Stay tuned. Coming up next, Kathy Lee Gifford in a winter wonderland.
Kids.
Merry Christmas!
Well, hello again, everybody. On behalf of Joan Lunden and myself, I'd like to wish you and all those kids a very Merry Christmas right back.
Aren't they, darling? Of course, that we're here with the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade, and it's great.
It sure is. It's better than Great Christmas Morning with Joan Lunden, Magic Kingdom. Come on, I'm having a ball. We've already seen so much, and we've got so much more to come. Aladdin, that's Beauty and the Beast, The Little Mermaid, I can't wait.
Hold on, Reg. Relax a little bit, you know? Enjoy the wonderful Christmas morning with the rest of us.
Joan, I can't. I'm sorry. Christmas just makes me go out of control.
All right, then let's take a break, okay? We'll go back down to the street with Robbie Benson somewhere in the Magic Kingdom to see how everyone else is enjoying this magic morning.
Hey, Joan and Regis. I'm here at Frontierland with a bit of a different view on today's parade. You know, back at home, you only see Main Street, but the parade actually snakes its way through Frontierland and Liberty Square before it even reaches Cinderella Castle. There are all sorts of reasons that people have for watching the parade at whatever location they choose, and I've got some real Frontierland fans with their top three reasons, okay? Reason number one, you get to see the parade before anybody else, right? Yeah! All right, reason number two, when the parade ends, you're just 2 minutes from Splash Mountain. Yeah! But reason number three, that's right. Turkey legs, okay? Now, if you've ever been here, you can't forget the delicious aroma from the Frontierland turkey leg cart. And today, Christmas dinner, Magic Kingdom style. Back to you, Regis and Joan. I think I'm going to join the crowd here.
I love those turkey legs.
They're a big happy.
All right, welcome back to Christmas morning here at Walt Disney World. You're looking at Main Street right there with the honey pot coming our way and the Pooh dancers out there in the front, which means Winnie the Pooh's right behind.
That's right. You know, I wonder how much honey that pot holds. It's a big one, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
There's Winnie the Pooh, and who's that little kid with him? That's Christopher Robin.
Yeah? Now, wait a minute. There she is.
That's my daughter, Lindsay.
Lindsay looking very good there.
Yeah, here they go. They've been rehearsing this number all week long. Yes, Winnie the Pooh and Tigger and Eeyore are right behind.
Now, I know you must be very nervous for Lindsay Jones. She's looking good so far.
But she's not nervous. She's having a blast.
Yes, she sure is.
They had costume fittings earlier in the week. Yesterday, she was up with rehearsals at 5:30 in the morning.
At dawn.
At dawn. Before dawn.
Yeah, this is a big thrill for her. And there's Tigger.
By this very minute.
Love Tigger.
They've just been great with her. And Christopher Robin, he's got, those are all his little childhood friends. They all live with Winnie the Pooh in the 100-acre wood.
This is her introduction to performing.
That's Kanga with baby Roo in her pocket, and Al is up there. The owl, of course, is the wisest of all the animals,
sure is,
right?
Sure is. They all live with Pooh in the 100-acre wood.
Yeah.
And live very happily, too. It's the holly that will be on your own
front door. Merry Christmas!
And look at these guys. These are guys, such a funny group. Scrooge McDuck, who brought the Magic Kingdom Counselor Miranda to life today. This is called Jumper.
And
Donald
that
up there, Scrooge right there.
Yeah, there he is. He's become quite popular, but my old favorite was Donald Duck. When I was a kid, I loved Donald Duck, and I loved the way he talks. And talked
Daisy,
then.
Too. I love Daisy.
He's never improved his speech, has he?
Do you think Donald's proposed to Daisy yet?
Jeez, I hope
I
so. It's
know.
Been a long time for her. She's
all
waited.
The little nephews are there. Look at them, Huey, Dewey, and Louie.
Mm-hmm. Which one is which? Do you know that, Joan Lunden?
No.
In fact, only Huey, Dewey, and Louie know for sure who they really are.
Donald's career began with a little bit role in The Wise Little Hen back in 1934.
Yeah.
He's short-tempered, but everybody loves him.
All right, guess what, Joan? It's traveling time again, and we're off to the Disney MGM Studios, where you can see real-life movie production happen right before your eyes every day. And this time, our old pal Kathy Lee Gifford took a few moments out from her busy shooting schedule to give us a look at how movie magic can make a winter wonderland happen right here in Florida. Kathy Lee.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Thank you, Rich. Here we are at the studio backlot. Look, already, Aladdin and Jasmine. Say hi to Abu, all right? This is really the heart of the studio where all the shooting for the TV shows and the movies takes place. Looks like they're expecting me too, huh? Come on inside. I want to show you all the magic of this place. Oh, they're so thrilled I'm here. This is what the interior of a busy soundstage really looks like. And as you can see, the crew's really busy getting ready for my big Christmas number. I'm gonna sing my brains out. Takes a lot of people behind the scenes to create what you actually see on your TV screen. Set designers, art directors,
far enough so they can paint that.
Lighting technicians, cameramen, Disney's Emmy Award-winning costumers, engineers, sound technicians. All work together to create the desired effect. The choreographer works to get the movement just right, while the director is responsible for bringing it all together.
Hi, I'm James Earl Jones at the Disney MGM Studios. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Beauty and the Beast, The Little Mermaid, and Mickey's new Fountain Splashtacular when we return.
Welcome back to Christmas morning at Walt Disney World, and everyone's having a ball on Main Street in the Magic Kingdom.
Yeah, even after all these years, it's such a treat to be here for Christmas morning.
Coming up, we've got a preview of a great new show at EPCOT 94 and a special top secret tour of a very scary attraction that's opening this summer, hosted by the one and only Regis Philbin.
Who just barely survived, I'm telling you, Joe, but I've got the clout to get the scoop on things you've never even dreamed about that's coming up.
Well, Reg, from one fantasy world to another, let's go back to Main Street for more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade. Winter Park Marching Band, 160 members, the Sound of the Wildcats from right here in Central Florida, under the direction of Mr. George Bolden.
They're playing Joy to the World. Let's listen. right, we're back now with the Disney Afternoon Float. All those great characters you see every afternoon on TV.
And these kids down here, these are from Showtime Dance Studios in Longwood, Florida. Three of these kids actually danced their way to a championship on Ed McMahon's Star Search. Mm. They're little Disney veterans, though. They've been in a lot of the shows around Disney World.
Uh-huh.
Good little dancers.
All right, well, let's see how many characters you can pick out here. Do you see Max, Goofy's son, anywhere?
Yeah, Max is up there. I think he's up there by...
Uh-huh.
The Darkwing Duck is up there.
Yeah. Launchpad the Quack.
Yep, there you go, there you go.
He's in the leather jacket, right?
Uh-huh, and there he is, right
there.
There
he is.
Hey,
wave
it to us.
He heard me.
All right,
Baloo then. Should be around there, too, somewhere, shouldn't
he's
he?
He's got a safari jacket on.
Yeah.
I saw him earlier. There's Launchpad McQuack up there,
mm-hmm.
along with Darkwing. There's Baloo.
Oh, Baloo, looking bigger and badder than ever.
The star of Tailspin. You know, Baloo made his screen debut in The Jungle Book.
Yes, he sure did. Now, the only one I haven't seen is Bonkers, the little bobcat.
He's up around there somewhere.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
Favorite, as you know, of my Sarah for years has been Little Mermaid.
Mm-hmm.
And she's got the whole gang out here. There he is. She is Ariel.
From under the sea to the Magic Kingdom. What a great movie that was. What a great attraction it is now.
And great music in the movie.
I tell you, if you come here, you must go over to the Disney MGM Studios and see The Little Mermaid.
Yeah, that's a fabulous show. Look at little flounder down there on the street.
Ariel's fishy friend.
There's Prince Eric,
yeah.
That handsome young man who won Ariel's heart.
Mm-hmm. Love the hair on Ariel.
Look at Sebastian has a little Christmas hat on. That's great. Let's go down to Main Street right now to our man on the street, Robbie Benson, who's on the lookout for some of his old friends. Robbie.
Hi, I'm down here on Main Street, and I'll tell you, this is the place to be if you're a fan of Disney movies. Now, we just saw The Little Mermaid, but we're all waiting for the arrival of Beauty and the Beast. It's a personal favorite of mine. I love the movie. In fact, so many people love it that it's been made into a musical extravaganza, and it's on its way to Broadway. Hey, look, here's a fan now. Hi, honey, what's your name?
Jenny.
Oh, and what's your favorite movie?
Beauty and the Beast.
Hi, what's your favorite movie?
They
all love it. Hi, honey. What's your name?
Daddy, you know my name.
My daughter. And what's your favorite movie, honey?
Aladdin.
You're killing me, honey. Anyway, we're all here. We want to see Beauty and the Beast, and it's coming right now. I just love these guys.
They bring out the beast in me.
All right, we're here. There's the Beast, and there was just Belle. You just saw
and
her a few minutes ago.
And you remember who the voice of
he was sensational.
Robbie Benson,
it surprised a lot of people when they first heard about that.
I like the Beast, and there's Belle.
And that's another great stage show you should see at the Disney
Absolutely.
MGM Studios, too.
And she was the young lady who always saw the good side of the Beast.
You know, Joan, for the last couple of years, I've been saying that show should be on Broadway. Well, it's finally on its way. It premiered in Houston, Texas a few weeks ago. Got great reviews. And
that's
on its way to
great.
Broadway this spring. Yeah, all those dancers you see on stage as well.
I love all the dancers and the enchanted objects.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this is Potts.
Mrs. Potts, the teapot. And the chip, that's Mrs. Potts' son,
yeah.
Isn't it? That's
and
right.
And the veneer is there too as well.
And Cogsworth, the clock.
All the enchanted objects.
Return to EPCOT 94 and Bill Nye,
the Science Guy.
The Science Guy, for a look at another new attraction there.
Hey, Bill Nye, the Science Guy here back at EPCOT 94 with some more wild stuff. And I want to talk first about something you might not think of as all that wild. I'm talking, of course, about water. Now, water covers 70% of the Earth's surface. It's two-thirds of you and me. Water is perhaps the most important substance known to humankind. And it's part of a brand new show here at EPCOT 94 called Splashtacular. It's
The engineers have worked with choreographers and musicians to make the fountains go in time with the music. And then at the end, there's this huge mechanical surprise. Okay, now, how did it turn out? Well, take a look for yourself. Coming up is Splashtacular. Yeah.
Okay, everybody. I think it's about time to see what this future world fountain can really do. Gosh, this sure is some fountain, but we need to add a little more color to the scene.
We'll be right back with Aladdin's Royal Caravan.
Welcome back. Beautiful golf course, one of the many, many resorts here at Walt Disney World. This is the Very Merry Christmas Parade. I've been saying that for 11 fun years.
11 years for you and 10 for me, the big 1-0 this year.
And never a dull moment. Every year, there have been so many new things to see and do.
And in the decade to come, we'll be showing you even more. They never stop around here. There are plans for an entire sports complex, new attractions, new resorts.
In fact, there are two new resorts opening this year. The All-Star Resort with its four-story football helmets, surfboards, and other big, giant sports symbols.
It's going to be great. And if you like the idea of staying in a rustic old National Park Lodge and watching Old Faithful, we've been watching this one go up for the last 2 years. The new Wilderness Lodge Resort on its way.
It sounds great now. Looks great. It's almost done.
Yeah, it's going to be fabulous. But listen to this. Listen, I've got the most thrilling new thing of all.
He does.
Come along with Regis for a personal Regis Philbin tour of something you're really going to fall for. I'm here at Disney's Future Projects Center for a sneak preview look at an exciting new attraction that's going to be opening up in the coming year. Come on in. I've got a lot to show you. Usually you need secret clearance to get into a place like this. Look at this, top secret. But with me, right in like that. Come on. Oh, here's my favorite, yeah. Ah, the real thriller. This is the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror. Wah! A thrilling new addition to the Disney MGM Studios. Now, it's going to take you on a creepy ride up 13 stories to the top of a deserted old Hollywood hotel. And then, suddenly, wham! The bottom falls out and you drop right to the bottom. Hey, this must be the model. Let's check it out. Come on. Gee, it looks a little scary, doesn't it? Almost looks like the real thing. I wonder if these doors open. They do. What do you think? Should I go inside? Huh? I'll try. Yeah, why not? Oh, yeah. Ma! Ma! Well, you know, it's not so bad after all. It's realistic, okay, but... Hey, what's happening here? What's going on? Holy mackerel, look at me! I'm black and white!
Picture, if you will, one of America's favorite talk show hosts. A man loved by millions, though sometimes prone to overacting. Trapped on a voyage into another dimension of the macabre. Next stop, the Twilight Zone.
I don't like this! Ma! Ma! Well, you know, it's not so bad after all. It's realistic, okay, but... Hey, what's happening here? What's going on? Holy mackerel, look at me! I'm black and white!
Picture, if you will, one of America's favorite talk show hosts. A man loved by millions, though sometimes prone to overacting. Trapped on a voyage into another dimension of the macabre. Next stop, the Twilight Zone.
I don't like this!
Listen, Joan, next year you do the new projects update. Right now I got a whole lot of suits to alter.
I love it. It's a whole new look for you, Reed, and one of my favorites. I'm sure there are a lot of people that are going to be looking forward to that one.
I thought you'd love that. Yes. Yeah. Summer 1994, everybody. Get ready. Mark your calendars. That's when the excitement begins.
Actually, the excitement can begin much sooner than that, because right now we're ready to bring you another Disney favorite.
Yeah, let's go out to Hollywood Boulevard at the Disney MGM Studios for some good old-fashioned genie magic and the start of Aladdin's Royal Caravan. There it is, the beautiful Disney MGM Studio Park. Now listen, Joan, I know we can't do this as well as Ed McMahon, but let's give it a try, okay?
All right.
One, two, three. Here's Genie!
I think we did that okay.
Not bad.
26 feet tall. That's a big blue guy coming down the street.
Three-story building, no doubt.
Look at the grin on his face, but you'd be happy too if you were the star of a movie as successful as Aladdin.
What, did it make over $200 million at the box office?
And I just read in the paper how the video has just become the top seller of all time.
Yeah, it's really a giant. It just shows you what a little genie magic can do.
Now look down there at the base. See that right down there on the float? That is the magical cave of wonders and the magical lamp.
Oh yeah, the magic lamp, sure.
Yeah, where Genie lives. Not too crazy about being trapped in there either, so he likes to get out like this.
It's part about being a genie. Phenomenal cosmic powers, itty-bitty living space.
Oh, look at the guardsmen. Nasty-looking fellows, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. But the people are all having a good time. But they are very imposing-looking.
Oh, sure. Absolutely.
But Aladdin takes care of those guys in the movie.
He sure does, doesn't he?
Yeah.
All of them. All their swords, everything.
They probably got a set of steak knives for Christmas, don't you think?
This parade goes down that main street a couple of times a day over at the Disney MGM Studio
Park. Yeah, Hollywood Boulevard. There's the band.
What's a parade without a brass band?
Now, the genie designed these costumes himself, I'm told.
Is that our genie cam? Looking right up the street. Oh, there's those nasty guys again. Woo.
Yeah.
Check out the sunglasses.
Hey, it's Hollywood Boulevard, isn't it?
Hey, yeah, on Hollywood Boulevard, you need some shades.
Robin Williams gave one of his greatest performances as the genie.
He sure did.
Kept those animators very busy.
Are we sure what they're doing there? A little balancing act, I'd say. Walking on their hands.
Yeah, okay.
Letting his hands do the walking.
And there's still more going on above them. Yeah, this is where the old Ed Sullivan show.
I think we saw these guys on the Ed Sullivan show years ago.
Well, here they go. Now, look out.
Oh, watch these
Don't
camels.
Let them get you. They're because, looking for the right target.
Because camels do spit, don't
yep.
they?
They're not ready.
Oh, our camel cam. Did you like that?
Yeah. Everybody's got a cam at this parade. Now watch out.
Oh! Well, they store up that water so that they can go for miles without a drink. Actually, they store fat in those pumps to give them energy, but it's a good story. Now, don't go away because we'll have much more of Aladdin's Royal Caravan and Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Parade when we return.
Hi, I'm Marley Matlin at the Disney MGM Studios. Happy holidays, everybody.
Prince Ali, Jasmine, and Jafar in Aladdin's Royal Caravan when we return.
Cowabunga! Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell swing and jingle bell spring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell chime in jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square, dude. In the frosty air, what a bright time. Is a bright time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time. Go gliding in a one-horse sleigh.
Whoa!
Jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock.
Oh, Marley!
Mix and a mingle and a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell rock.
All right, Jim, let's go for pizza.
Love those Ninja Turtles. Yeah, I gotta say it, Joel. Please
right,
let me
ahead,
say
ahead.
It. Every year, this is one chance to say it. Get ready. Cowabunga!
I like to say cowabunga. Thank you, Reg.
Good.
I'm sure the Mutant Ninja Turtles just really appreciate it. Now, we've just got a little tiny peek at their show over at the studios.
And later on in the show, we'll have a chance to take a look at a new show at Epcot 94 starring the one and only Barbie.
I know. Yeah. That sounds exciting. But right now, let's get back to more of the Genie show, Aladdin's Royal Caravan, coming down Hollywood Boulevard back to the studios.
All right, so the question is, where does a 24-foot gorilla float?
Anywhere
he wants. Look at the size of this guy.
He's 24 feet long.
Yep.
Takes a lot of people to carry a giant gorilla down the street.
How many would you say?
Maybe 16.
Mm-hmm, I think you're right.
Great shot there, Hollywood Boulevard.
Absolutely. There's the old crossroads. Longtime landmark in Hollywood.
The slaves are a little tangled up there trying to keep the guy down.
Yeah, they sure are.
Caught up in their work.
Mm-hmm. And how? The bathtub camel now. That's quite a feat.
Well, I gotta keep the genie clean, right?
This guy's trying to steal some hotel towels, I think.
The fuck float. You never know what you're going to see there. You've got those rope climbers. They do a lot of social climbing.
The frontiers know how to live there, look. Got their own little harem.
Those are the snake girls, Reed. You know, it's the classic story of a girl and her snake. Wearing her boa.
Oh, this is my favorite guy. The guy that can lay down on the nails. Yeah.
What, you relate to that?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I did that once.
Is your life like that?
Another snake girl.
A snake charmer.
Yeah, they're welcoming Prince Ali.
And what a reception Aladdin is getting today.
Oh, yeah, here they are.
Well, it takes some big guys, right, to haul around all the enormous wealth of Prince Ali.
Can you imagine how wealthy all those beautiful bubbles and bangles?
Yeah, well, you got to be impressed by all these gems. Even you, a diamond in the rough.
This crowd may think they're getting them for Christmas. No, oh, there they are.
Jasmine.
Yeah, Jasmine and Prince Ali.
Looks like they're on that magical carpet.
Looking around for Abu. Remember him?
Absolutely, one of my little favorites.
Little monkey, I'll see him.
But I'd like a magic carpet.
Hey, who wouldn't?
Can you imagine? That'd be cool.
Can you imagine your own magic carpet beat that New York traffic?
Well, that's one carpet that does not let people walk all over him, right? Fortunately, that mean guy Jafar hasn't been around yet.
Not yet, but you know, he's always lurking. Oh, wait a minute.
Ah, there he is. We knew that that nasty villain couldn't be too far behind. Snarly fella.
I would say. But Aladdin is not one to hold grudges, so Jafar still has a job to really clean up in his new career.
Is a great parade, and if you're planning a trip down here, you shouldn't miss that one.
Absolutely not. The caravan captures all the color and the music and the feeling of the movie.
And when it comes to capturing the feeling of Christmas, no one does it like Walt Disney World.
The decorations are everywhere, and so are the warm feelings that go along with the Christmas season.
Let's go down to the castle right now, where Robbie Benson is taking in all that holiday flavor.
Robbie!
Thanks, Joan and Regis. Hey, could there be a more magical place to spend Christmas morning than right here? This is great. You know, the only thing that's missing is Christmas carols. And there's nothing like singing your favorite Christmas carols. Come here. Hi, what's your name?
Sarah.
Do you have a favorite Christmas carol?
Yes.
What is it?
Jingle bells.
Can you sing it for me? Okay.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. How fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh.
That's great. It's tough to compete with the chipmunks, isn't it? I bet we could do it. Deck the halls, okay? Everybody, deck the halls. Ready?
Deck the halls with bells.
I love it. Christmas morning, carols, all these great decorations. You know, this place is decked out with more than 4 miles of garland, 850 Christmas trees. So what does it feel like to be in the middle of all this holiday magic? Well, just sing along with us and take a look at this.
At Disney is wonderful.
So Christmassy, that Santa will love it here.
I think this is where Santa comes for his Christmas.
Yep.
Coming down here has really made the Christmas spirit come alive for us.
It's nice to be in a place that loves children and Christmas, because that's what Christmas is about.
Merry Christmas.
James Seymour at the Disney MGM Studios. Merry Christmas, everyone.
The all-new magical world of Barbie when the Very Merry Christmas Parade continues.
The weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. We've got to show signs of stopping, but we brought some corn and coffee. The lights are turned way down low.
Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Somewhere else, somewhere else, somewhere else.
We're having a blast here at the Magic Kingdom, and there's still more fun ahead, including a terrific musical number from EPCOT 94's World Showcase with the one, the only, John Davis.
But right now, let's go back to Main Street for a look at Christmas Mississippi style.
Mississippi style. Here's that big showboat.
Now, this is the largest float in the parade. It's 23 feet tall. Just makes it under all the garland.
65 feet in length as well. Yeah, that's
and look at the guys up there. There's Greer Bear and Greer Fox and Greer Rabbit.
The rest of the year, you catch them on Splash Mountain.
Have you been on Splash Mountain?
Oh, I have.
It's great. Such a great ride. Huh?
It's really a thrill.
There are all the dancers there. We got our Dixieland musicians.
Speaking of dances, every year they have those clog dances coming up right around this time.
That follows a zippity-doo-dah.
Zippity-doo-dah. Okay, all right.
Quad dancers, along with your scarecrows.
The dancing scarecrows dancing to a country Christmas. They do something, the scarecrows do a piece of business here with their legs. It's really incredible.
It's fun to see. Now, the quad dancers, of course, are called quaggers because they wear those big, heavy wooden shoes. Called quads. Looks like she's got her tennis shoes on there.
Nice try, Joan.
Now, watch this and just see if you can figure it out. People along the street always try to figure out how these scarecrows do their dance.
I know. Boy, they are loose, aren't they? Hey, Wagon Time, you know what that means.
That means Wendell and Liverlips and Shaker are coming our way from the Country Bear Jamboree.
They just love the holidays, these guys. They usually decorate Grizzly Hall and put on a special Christmas show. But they're with us today.
A little more dancing today, but they just couldn't bear to do that.
You know, I would thought you were going to say that. Hey, look who's here.
It's Barbie, one of the newest members of the Disney family.
Now let's
and
stop.
She's got Ken next
yeah,
to her.
Yeah, there he is. Yeah, boy. Oh, yes.
Little Skipper's in the car there with them.
Wow. Barbie, how are you? Merry Christmas.
Well, Merry Christmas to you. Hello, Regis and Joan, and welcome.
You look just beautiful today, and Ken's not bad either.
Well, thank you very much. It's so great to be here on Christmas with all of my special friends this morning. And guess what? Skipper, Ken, and I can't wait to show you our new show. It's the Magical World of Barbie, and it's at EPCOT 94. We'd love to see you there, so please come. And wait a minute, why don't we just look at a clip?
Barbie's world, there's no limitations in Barbie's
no
world.
No problem.
There's nothing you can't do in Barbie's world. Use your imagination and make your dreams come true. Come with us, ride this way. Come with us, let's go play in Barbie's world.
There's no city like the city in the land.
family from Naples, Florida, wishing you and yours a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Coming up next, John Davidson at EPCOT's World Showcase.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back. We're coming to you from Walt Disney World.
Another great Christmas morning here, and we just got a report. Santa Claus was sighted over Hartford, Connecticut. He's on his way to us. He'll be here very soon.
Should be any minute now, but look who's coming down Main Street right now. Yeah, Mrs. Claus doing a little advance work for Santa, I guess. Let's see what she's up to.
She's got some friends along.
Uh-huh. She does it all, doesn't she?
Those are little Santa's elves there, and the candy canes coming down Main Street.
I love that candy house, too.
There's Mrs. Claus.
She's not bad, Mrs. Claus.
She's the First Lady of the North Pole.
Yeah, she can't wait. It's been a long night for him out in the sky somewhere.
And look at that gingerbread house. It's the only edible residence in the world.
And notice the whipped cream just going right over her bowl there.
Where would they make a house like that?
And the candy maid dancers bought costumes from that Emmy Award-winning costuming department we have
here
at Walt Disney World.
3,500 different costumes, about 2.5 million pieces. It is an incredible place.
It's the world's largest.
Yep.
You get lost in there for days and days and days. First, in fact, the only edible residence in the
yep.
world.
Right.
Like to see where they baked that, but that is a beautiful house, isn't it? Look.
There are candy canes moving down the street.
The gingerbread men are here. Sure.
Now, just behind this group, oh, look at these guys. That's the spoon in the bag of flour there. And they got the gingerbread men.
Keep your buddy busy making those cookies on a day like this.
You know, in the Middle Ages, monks made gingerbread in monasteries, and they were actually the first one to start cutting them into all the little fancy shapes like animals and birds and things. Hey, there's Chip and Dale.
Chip and Dale. Now, how do you know them apart?
Because Chip has one tooth, Dale has two, and Chip's nose is darker, right? And there's Dale.
He's sure
dancing away there. And your eyebrows are slightly different, too. Really close. Close. Now, there are the little gingerbread cookies. Look. See, they laid themselves right down to be baked. Let's go.
Thank you.
continues down Main Street. We'll go back over now to EPCOT 94. Bill Nye,
the science guy,
is experiencing the International Flavor of the World Showcase. I wonder what he thinks of it.
Yeah, I wonder what Bill thinks.
The Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade will continue in a moment.
Hey, Bill Nye, the science guy here at EPCOT 94's World Showcase. You know, what I love about this place is you get a chance to see firsthand the distinct cultures of the world. Like right now, we're in Morocco. Because the people who work at World Showcase actually come from the cultures they represent, it really drives home the idea of how diverse culture and languages are.
La Bess.
Anyway, do you know that scientists have discovered over 4,000 spoken languages? Now that's diversity.
Sana Saida.
Happy holidays to you.
Shukran.
F1. Anyway, but now here's John Davidson to put it all another way in a special Christmas show where he's going to communicate something we all have in common.
Japan. Te amo, ya te vi a libre, a ni ojevet otra, I love you. The sounds are all so different as the worlds from which they came, and though our words are all unique, our hearts are still the same. Us worlds apart, there's no misinterpreting the language of your heart.
Hello everyone, greetings from the UK.
Merry Christmas and a jolly good new year. Cheers.
Hallo from Germany, ich wünsche Ihnen schöne Weihnachten und ein gesegnetes Fest. Auf Wiedersehen.
Orangutan in Mexico.
Feliz Navidad.
Prospero Año Nuevo.
Y Felicidad.
Joyeux Noël.
In Norway we say,
Fuyul.
Oh, I'm fine, Feria.
Benson.
Merry Christmas. 楽しいひとときを家族と一緒にお過ごしくださいませ.
Joyeux Noël. From Canada, eh?
From China. Nei ho, chukawai sengdan failo.
Saluti from Italy. Buon Natale. Felice Anno Nuovo e buone vacanze.
Happy holidays from Morocco.
And as we say here at the American Adventure, Merry Christmas from World Showcase, EPCOT Center.
Georgia. And we want to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We'll be right back with more of the Very Merry Christmas Parade.
You are looking at Pleasure Island and Walt Disney World, and we're having a great morning here in the Magic Kingdom, the most magical place to spend Christmas.
And we've got a front row seat on everything happening throughout this tremendous resort.
Later on, we'll be going to Epcot 94 for a terrific song by a very special group of kids.
But right now, come on, we're going to go back to Main Street and join someone who's been out there all morning checking on everything, our man of the street, Robbie Benson. Robbie!
Hey, Regis. You know, the Christmas parade here at the Magic Kingdom has become such a great tradition for people. Folks come out here to be a part of this event year after year after year. Now, let me ask you something. This isn't your first year here, is it?
No way.
How many years?
This is our third year here.
Third year. How about you guys?
We've been coming 9 years. We love it.
9 years. And is this the same spot?
Try to be. Yep. Try to be here every year.
That's tradition. Right now, it sounds like it's time for another great Disney tradition, the Grand Calliope.
Oh, yay!
Well, tradition is right. Walt Disney bought this calliope himself back in 1940.
Mm. These are the Percherons we were talking about earlier pulling that calliope. World champion 8-horse hitch.
They are gigantic, about 6 feet tall if you're standing on the ground, just up to their, what's called the withers, their shoulders.
Awarded that honor at a Calgary Stampede a few years ago.
It's a beautiful thing, and they really restored it beautifully.
Mm-hmm.
Now, just behind the calliope is the Toy Factory. A lot going on this one, but look who's up front there. That's Goof.
Yep.
Oh, Goofy.
Goof dressed up as Santa Claus. What's he got on his hand there? Is that his present for this year?
Ah, Goofy has a present with him this morning. It's a brand new sailboat.
Goofy wants a sailboat. He got
nice sailboat. He could sail the Seven Seas Lagoon down here in that little sailboat.
And those are the toys that every kid's wanted through the years, Raggedy Ann, every one of them. Toy plane, the toy box, the toy car.
Teddy bear.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Goofy just turned 60 years old last year. He doesn't look like it.
Kidding.
I always loved Raggedy Ann.
Yeah.
Andy.
Sure.
Now,
that.
You know, he made his debut, Goofy did, in Mickey's Review in 1932, and his original name was Dippy Dog. Yeah, I'm serious. It was
Goofy
Dog.
Dippy Dog. Hey, here's the toy train. One of Disney's most colorful floats, an express train nonstop from the North Pole to sunny Florida.
And it's just packed with toys, fresh from Santa's workshop.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Roger!
Hey, Roger Rabbit!
Maroon Cartoon's biggest star.
Yep, from Who Framed Roger Rabbit? The number one box office champ of 1988.
And incidentally, his car, that cartoon spin, is located right in the heart of downtown Toontown.
Look at all the little pool toys. That was Donald Duck, your favorite.
Yeah, I know.
And all these clowns out there, and they go right up to the audience.
Clown band, the silliest bunch of serious musicians you'll ever meet anywhere.
Yeah, they happen to be very good. Oh, look at her.
Yes,
I love all those little faces,
brightly lit on this morning, and what an incredible morning it is, too, at the Magic Kingdom.
But the fun is not over yet. Don't move, because when we come back, as promised, the one and only Santa Claus.
You think he brought us some presents, Joan, huh?
Only if you've been good, Reed.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, stick around. We're coming right back with the grand finale of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade right after this.
I'm Taryn.
And I'm Jonathan.
From Home Improvement.
And we're at the Disney MGM Studios.
Happy holidays, everyone!
Don't go away. Santa Claus is coming your way in the grand finale to the Very Merry Christmas Parade.
What what a gorgeous shot of the Magic Kingdom, and we're just a few minutes away from the grand finale of the Walt Disney World Very Merry Christmas Parade.
You can feel the excitement. The crowd's buzzing with anticipation.
I sense that Santa is just about here, Joan.
Well, you're not the only one, Reese. Down on Main Street, everyone has come out to welcome Santa to the Magic Kingdom.
This is like his last stop, isn't it?
Absolutely. Yep. This is his time of the year. His season.
That's a good sign he's here.
All right, let's do it. There's Dasher, Dancer, Prancer,
Vixen,
Comet, Cupid,
Donka,
Donner, and Blitzen.
And of course, wait a minute, there's one more.
I was just waiting to see if we saw him different than the rest.
Check the nose.
Where's Rudolph?
Oh, damn.
And just behind the reindeer and all the little Santa's helpers, we've got your favorite, the Glock girls, the Glock players. The Glockenspiel players.
Uh-oh, I think this is it. Yes,
there
yes,
he is.
He's made it, and there he is.
The star of the day, Santa himself.
Hi, floating high above Main Street.
Old St. Nick.
Still got a bag full of toys behind him.
And he is starting a well-deserved vacation here in Walt Disney World, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
He's put in a very long night, actually a long year.
Yeah.
Checking on everyone, he's good and bad.
But he always looks refreshed. I mean, you know, can't keep Santa down. Crowd very happy to see him and all the kids looking forward to a personal visit.
Look at that scene up Main Street.
It's fabulous.
Another
okay,
great
he
morning.
He made it. Don't go away yet, because we've got two very special surprises for you right now.
Ah, yes, the Walt Disney World Children's Honor Choir, a wonderful group of children from five different counties here in Central Florida, and they put together a very special song for us.
This is terrific. Under the direction of Dr. Bert Perenchi, they'll be singing a beautiful arrangement of Let There Be Peace on Earth.
But first, here's another surprise, a very special message for all the people watching today's telecast around the country and around the world. Here is President Bill Clinton and First Lady Hillary Clinton with a Merry Christmas wish to us all.
Merry Christmas, America, from our family to yours. Christmas is a day for families. Its magic somehow brings even the closest of families closer. It reaches across the long stretches on the map and over the high walls in our minds that too often keep us apart. Distance and misunderstanding fall quickly in the face of the Christmas spirit. I won't be the first to say that the warmth of this one December day can work miracles for a family. It happens all the time. So as you celebrate this holiday season, I hope you'll spend some time thinking about our American family, 260 million strong, a family challenged by challenging times, but a family capable of just about anything when it comes together.
Merry Christmas, everyone. You know, the warmth and joy of holiday fellowship is so uplifting. I hope that we can carry a little of it with us throughout the coming year.
That's the Christmas spirit. Let's do our very best this year to instill every day with the love and compassion of the holiday season, to hold a little Merry Christmas in our hearts 365 days a year. Have a joyous holiday and a happy new year. God bless you all.
absolutely magic morning here in the Magic Kingdom. Merry Christmas, everybody, and thanks for watching. And thanks to Bill Nye and John Davidson and my good pal, Kathy Lee Gifford, not to mention this guy right here, Robbie Benson.
Thanks a lot. Merry Christmas, Regis and Joan, and Merry Christmas to my whole family. This is my daughter, Lyric, my little boy, Zephyr, and I love you, Carla.
And also to my daughters, Jamie, our little Disney dancer, Lindsay, and Sarah. And happy holidays, everyone. And
Merry Christmas.
The Walt Disney World's Very Merry Christmas Parade, brought to you by Kissimmee St. Cloud, with over 29,000 quality accommodations. Location is our biggest attraction. And Johnson's Baby Shampoo, because your baby is all that matters. And Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Talent accommodations provided by the many Walt Disney World Resort hotels. There's only one thing better than visiting the Walt Disney World Resort in Florida: staying there.